Welcome back to the channel. Unless this is like your first time here. If so, hey. We back with another story time. This is another shorter one, I guess. But it's something. It'll entertain you. So this is back in high school. You know, I just got my first car. You know, I'm whipping, I'm driving people around, even though I'm not legally supposed to be driving people around yet. But you know, we still living, we still having fun, we still being young, all that. Like one weekend, like during the school year and shit, I didn't have anything going on. And one of my homies, he's like a grade lower than me. He hits me up and he's like, "Hey, I'm trying to go to this girl's house so I can." You feel me? Me being like the people pleaser I was back in the day, like I didn't. It was like whatever, like fine, I'll whip you over there, y'all, and then I'll skirt out and you give me the money, the gas money and shit, and it's cool. So I drive buddy over there. He sneaks in through like their back door and shit. I'm still like parked out up front. Looking back on it, this is like really fucking stupid. Like that was not sneaky at all. Anyways, he goes in there. He's not in there too long. You know what I'm saying? He does his shit. He gets in, gets out. You know, like he gets his nut off. Good for him, I guess. I drive him back to his spot. You know, I go back home. I do whatever. You know, like I don't really think about it beyond that. The next weekend, another one of my homies, grade below, hits me up. And he's like, "Hey, I'm trying to go to the girl's house. Because I heard you drove my homie over there and I'm trying to zoo." And I'm like, "Well, you know what? Fine. This is cool. Like, they both have gas money and stuff. I can drive people around and shit. Like, I got a car now. I'm grown. You know what I'm saying?" So, the second dude, he gives me the address so I can, you know, whip up to this place and shit. And the address a little familiar. And I get into the neighborhood and I'm like, "Oh, I've been here before. I've been here before." Then I get to the house and I'm like, "What?" The same chick come outside talking about some trying to sneak the nigga in and shit. And I didn't want to just chill in the car because I ain't even have that much gas in my shit. So like I didn't want to just like have that bit running. So I went inside with him. And I'm like, "All right, y'all, do y'all whatever, go upstairs and I'ma chill downstairs. I'ma just like sit on the couch or some shit." Yeah. So like 2-3 minutes in, I'm just sitting there like on my phone. I was probably on like Kick or something, because it was like, this was a while ago. And it's just boom, 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 boom. Like he's going crazy up in that bit, you know what I'm saying? It was almost like Grinding by Clips was playing. Like it was thumping. "I'm your pusher. The world
is about to feel something that they never felt before.
Come on." So in my head, I'm like, "Yeah, well, they might take a little while. They seem to be really enjoying it, I guess." And in my head, I'm like, gas money can't be the only thing I get out of this. I get up from the couch. And I make my way towards the kitchen, and I'm like, "Let's see what this bitch got to eat." I go in there, this is like sandwich meat, and like, you know, like shit that I'll either have to like heat up or like go out of my way to make, and like, I'm not doing all that shit in somebody else's house. But then I pull one of them little drawers out, and they got these like little yogurt joints in there, you know what I'm saying? My black ass is like, "I like yogurt." So I bust one of those bitches out. The package was like not even open. Like they like just got that bitch, by the way. So I bust one of those bitches out. I don't get no spoon or nothing because I don't want to dirty no dishes. I just start eating that bitch up. Then all of a sudden, like I'm like a third of the way into the yogurt and I hear them stop. This fast nutting ass nigga gonna walk his way down the steps and then come into the kitchen. "Hey bro, what you doing?" "No nigga, what are you doing? You was up there for like 4 minutes. I'm sitting there like these and shit. I got fucking yogurt in my mustache and whatnot. Like I just look dumb as fuck, but like I'm caught red-handed. I gotta live up to it now. And shortly after, old girl walks her way down the steps too, and then she sees me and she's like, "Are you eating my little sister's yogurt?" And I was like, "Shit, I guess I am." And like it's like nothing really like tense or anything. Like they laugh it off. I'm laughing too, and it's like whatever. I'm about to leave. Then old buddy's like, "Hey, bruh. You want some too?" And I like turn around and I was like, "What do you mean? Do I, like, what are you offering? What?" And she's like, nah, she down to fuck if you want it. Like I wasn't in there that long if you trying, you know what I'm saying? And I just stopped. I felt my face drop. Every part of my body just dropped. And like, I could tell that this was normal to them and obviously not normal to me. So I wanted to like make it seem like it was normal to me. I was like, nah, man, I done fucked a lot of bitches this week. I don't need no more. Mind you, I was still a virgin at the time, but me telling the story really got inspired by someone, like one of my homies in like the group chat that I'm in. He like sent me a picture of this girl, and he's like, "Hey, I'm thinking about shooting my shot, bro. What should I do?" And it was that girl that was like getting ran through in high school by like all of my friends. Because I mean, like, some people don't care, you know, like a car can have mileage, a pussy can have mileage, like, and they both drive good for a while, I guess. But you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna send this video to you, my boy, and you do what thou wilt, as they say. Moral of the story is wear protection. Like, comment, subscribe.